Well, good morning, church family. It is Thursday morning, April the 30th, and I hope and pray that today you are doing well and excited about the news that Florida and Fernandina, Amelia Island will start opening up a little bit. I hope that has put a little spark into your day today. And then also, you know, the beaches are going to open some tomorrow and then some on Monday. So that's exciting for those of you that like the beach. Today's passages come out of Psalm chapter 56. I'm going to skip around a little bit in them as I'm reading them, but you can follow along. And it's a little bit different today. It does, the phrases, I shall not be afraid are in them. It's not necessarily God telling us, do not be afraid or do not fear, fear not, that type of phrase. But the phrase that's in here is, I shall not be afraid. And it's, this is when David was kind of scared of the king of Gath at the time. He was the Philistines in Gath. He was fleeing from Saul and went to Gath and was scared of the kings of Gath. And so he wrote this psalm during that time. He was afraid of what was going to happen to him, and you can hear that in the passages when we read it. But after we read it, I'll tell you the truth of God's word today and who God is, and I hope and pray that it will resonate with your heart today and that you would be encouraged this day. So let's read Psalm chapter 56. Says, be gracious to me, O God, for man tramples on me. All day long, an attacker oppresses me. My enemies trample on me all day long, for many attack me proudly. When I am afraid, I put my trust in you. So when I am afraid, I put my trust in you. In God, whose word I praise, in God I trust, I shall not be afraid. What can flesh do to me? And then skip down to verse 9, says, then my enemies will turn back in the day when I call. This I know, that God is for me. Now let me repeat that again. This I know, that God is for me. In God, whose word I praise, in the Lord, whose word I praise, in God I trust, I shall not be afraid. What can man do to me? Over and over in this scriptures, in this passage, David is writing, he says the situation, and he tells you the situation. He says, for man is trampling on me all day long, an attacker oppresses me. He is crying out to God, saying, God, this is the situation. But then David says his response. Now that's so important for us to understand this. He's crying out to God, saying, God, this is my situation. But then he says, but God, this is my response. And the situation is bleak. It's bad. There's things going on. He could die. He doesn't know. He could be hurt. He doesn't know. Just like in our situation, things seem kind of bleak sometimes. We're hurt. Things seem horribly bad. That's the situation. But David's response is this. He says, when I am afraid, I put my trust in you. In God, whose word I praise, in God I trust, I shall not be afraid. And then again down in the bottom it says in verse 9, when my enemies will turn, then my enemies will turn back in the day when I call. This I know, that God is for me. In God I trust, I shall not be afraid. David's crying out, saying, this is a situation, and then his response is, in God I trust. I put my trust in you. In verse 3, it says, when I am afraid, I put my trust in you. And so, whatever your situation is, my prayer is that whatever your situation, whatever my situation is, my prayer is that you will be able to respond the way David did. My prayer is that I will be able to respond the way David did. If I'm hurt, if I'm struggling, I'm going to say, but God, in you, I put my trust. And the reason we can do that, and this is the truth of who God is God is trustworthy. He is trustworthy. No matter what you're going through, He is trustworthy. Doesn't mean you won't hurt. Doesn't mean you won't feel pain. Doesn't mean you won't go through hard seasons. It doesn't mean that you don't feel like you'll never get out of your hard season. But the thing about it is God is trustworthy. And eventually that season will be over. This season will be over. So whatever the situation, our response should be just like David's. And in you, God, I trust. I put my trust in you. No matter the situation, I'm going to put my trust in you. So what is your response today to Him? My prayer is that you will put your trust into Him and to God. I love you, church family. Let's pray. God, I just thank you for your Son Jesus and the grace and mercy that comes through Him. And God, I'm praying for us today. Some of us are really experiencing a hard time. God, some of us are struggling. Lord, some of us are not even struggling with the COVID issues. We're struggling with other life issues, God, and pain and hurt. And Lord, my prayer is that through all of this, God, that we can say, God, we can come to you, number one. We can say, God, here's our situation, but I'm going to trust you. And that's hard to do, but my prayer is that we are able to do that. And the reason we can do that, God, is because you are trustworthy. God, let us lean into you today because you are trustworthy. God, I love you. I want to honor you with everything I am. In Jesus' name, amen. So church family, lean into God today. Let our response be, God, I put my trust in you. No matter what the situation is, our response, God, I trust you. Just like in Psalm 56. I love you, church family. I miss you. I hope you're doing well today. I want to encourage you. The season is hopefully over. Will be over soon. And I love you. Remember to listen to the truth of God's word. And in Christ Jesus, there is always hope. God bless, and I'll see you tomorrow.